All right, so in example six, we're asked to actually take a graph now and find a possible formula for this function. Okay, now these periodic functions actually have an infinite number of formulas that could represent them, but we're just going to find one. So, all right, let's take a look at what's going on here. First thing I would probably do is look at the period. So let's look at the distance between the asymptotes. All right, so I've got the asymptotes for one cycle go from minus pi over 4 to 3 pi over 4. Okay, so that's a period of pi. So the period is equal to pi, which is what our normal tangent function has. It has a period of pi. So now we know that there's no horizontal stretch or compression going on. Okay, so there's no value of b. There's no multiplier on theta. Okay. You can also see that, okay, so here's right in the middle, and you can see that halfway in between, it looks like we're at 1 and minus 1. So there's no horizontal, or sorry, vertical stretch or compression going on either. So we've essentially got y is equal to tangent of theta, but then we do have a horizontal shift going on. We have a horizontal translation. So we need to know how far is it translated. It's translated it, you know, we could if we assume that we're starting out but with our normal tangent function has asymptotes at minus pi over 2 and positive pi over 2. So it looks like it's just shifted. The easiest shift would just be by pi over 4 to the right. Okay. So we're going to assume that it's just a translation of by pi over 4 to the right. So it's shifted to the right by pi over 4. So shifting to the right would mean that I had to subtract pi over 4, right? Because now then it would take pi over 4 more to get the same amount of output. Okay? So that's essentially it. It's a matter of looking at the period, looking at the stretch or compression in both the horizontal and vertical directions. Now, the horizontal compression is going to be determined, co stretch or compression is going to be determined by the period. Any vertical stretch or compression is going to be determined by these points on either side of zero, right? Because they would normally go through 1 and minus 1. If they are stretched or compressed, they're going to go through something else. And that's pretty much it. All right, so that takes care of that example.